Hello everyone, this is Sam Spade, and in this tutorial we're going to talk about the built-in alarms, the ones that come with GameMaker Studio 2.3. And this tutorial is part of the unnecessarily long series about alarms in GameMaker Studio 2.3. Let's actually jump straight over to GameMaker Studio 2. So, what is a built-in alarm? A built-in alarm essentially is a variable that's held in the alarm array, so this is the alarm right here, held in the alarm array, that holds a value. And if it is above zero, it counts down. And if it hits zero, it goes off and does whatever is in the alarm event. So that's what the built-in alarm is, a value that counts down and goes off as zero. Now, how can you interact with it? Well, as you can see, one thing you can do, of course, is set the alarm. To set the alarm, you simply assign a value to the alarm that is greater than zero. So this will set the alarm to 60. You can cancel the built-in alarms by setting them to -1. If you ever want to know what value is held by the alarm, you simply check the value held by this variable. So an example using all of these together is if alarm 0 is equal to -1. So here we are checking the value held in this variable. We're comparing it to its off variable. And if it is off, we are setting it to room speed. Next, let's talk about how alarms run. So if I come over here, you can see my alarm. It only has the create event and the alarm 0 event that we were already looking at. Create alarm 0. Note that there's no step event or anything else like that. And that's because the built-in alarms run automatically. If their value is higher than 0, they count down. So you don't actually need to run the alarm. GameMaker will do it for you. The important thing to note is that GameMaker, though, because it's doing it for you, only decreases the alarm's value by 1 every step. And this means that alarms, the built-in alarms, are tied to the frames per second. So an alarm that is set to 60 will last for a second if you are at 60 frames per second, and will last for 2 seconds if you are at 30 frames per second. And there's no way to change that. GameMaker controls it for you. You can't really make or destroy alarms. They just exist. You can use up to 12 though. So you have alarm 0 through 11 that just sort of exist available for your use if you want them. And there you go. That's really all there is to it, to built-in alarms. They are very straightforward and easy to use. In fact, we can diagram them pretty simply. There are essentially two elements to them. There's the alarm variable, and again, I'm going to keep using 0, but this could be 0 through 11. And there's the alarm event. These are the two parts to the built-in alarm that you have access to. You can set the alarm by providing a value to this. You can cancel it by turning it to -1, and you can get the remaining time simply by checking what value is held. You can tell it what to do when the alarm goes off by writing code in the alarm event. The alarm runs, but it does so automatically. You have no control over it. Not only is it locked away from you, but it's also automatic. It will run every step. You can't make any more of them, and you also can't name them. So at this point, we've answered the two questions: what is a built-in alarm, and how do you interact with it? Now we can evaluate it. The pros of the built-in alarm are that they're simple, easy to use, automated, and very stable. You know exactly what you're getting, you know how to use them, and you know they're essentially never going to break. However, the cons of the built-in alarms are that there is a limited number of them, although 12 is generally going to be sufficient. There are cases where it might not be. You can't really name them, and most importantly, they're tied to frames. Again, they run every step. If you want to run an alarm with delta time, you cannot use the built-in alarms. If you want to speed up or slow down an alarm, you can't really do it. This can be a very significant negative. So there you go. That's an overview of the built-in alarms in GameMaker Studio 2, what they are, and how to interact with them, along with a list of some of their pros and cons. And that's it. Thanks for watching.